Okay, so we're using a fairly new siding product today called Smart Side Smooth, and I really like it. I'm going to tell you the reasons why I like it better than Hardie for installing, and give you some good tips on how to put up this smooth Smart Side on any house you're siding yourself. First of all, you can actually cut this Smart Side with a regular saw, a regular table saw, a regular chop saw, and so it's a lot faster to get fit and put in place, and that's my number one reason why I think it's a better product to install. Usually when you have to cut Hardie board, you cut it with either nippers that kind of break the board so you don't make too much dust, but that dust, if you do have to cut it with a grinder, is extremely bad for you. Contains silica particles, which if they get in your lungs, they're too small to get out and it can cause cancer. So that makes it a lot harder to install. That's another reason why cutting with a regular saw is a huge advantage. Here, go ahead, touch it.
Smooth.
It's like shark skin.
It's got a slight wood grain to it.
It is like a shark skin, isn't it? I touch sharks all the time. It's just like a shark. What do you think?
Nice. Don't get too excited.
Real nice.
Real nice.
That seems really exciting. One other awesome thing about this Smart Side is one person can actually carry a 16-foot board. And actually, the fact that you can get 16-foot boards, with the Hardie panel, you're looking at 12-foot planks in most cases because it's so flimsy.
What?
But this stuff is a lot lighter, and you can actually pick it up with one person and carry it around, which is a huge advantage when you're trying to pass it up. Like way up high on scaffolding and stuff like that. Having this in 16-foot pieces is going to get you a lot less butt joints, so it's going to look a lot better as a finished product. Side looks like, it kind of looks like OSB, but it's, I'd call it super compressed. It's super dense compared to regular OSB. You can smack this stuff with a hammer as hard as you can. Go ahead and smack a piece. See that? Like it doesn't even dent. It's crazy hard. That's crazy.
And it's smooth.
So this Smart Side is a lot tougher, I guess you'd call it. We're gonna do a little experiment here called the impact test. First, we're gonna smack the Smart Side with a hammer, right there. Let me get in close now. Go for it.
Ooh!
God, that was loud. Okay, next. Impact test. Next, right there, buddy. We're gonna smack the Hardie board with a hammer. This is from the last job. Okay, so that was same setup there, and the Hardie board just destroyed. That was impact test number two. And just for fun, impact test on the Smart Side. Watch out. So the biggest question a lot of people are going to have if you're worried about money is, how much does this stuff cost and how much are you going to save or lose using it? So I got on Lowe's.com and I got the price comparison. Based on the current pricing from Lowe's, a 16-foot log board of Smart Side by 8 inches is $12.92 versus $12.40 for a 12-foot long board by 8 inches in the Hardie. Okay, so we're blind nailing this siding on every stud and in between every stud with 2.5-inch galvanized siding nails. And that's a lot of nails, but that's what the instructions say. That's what we're doing. Another time-saving tip when you're doing lap siding is to make a story pole or a layout pole, whatever you want to call it. And we usually do this, right, save, so I don't throw it away. And this has the layout of each row of siding already marked, so you don't have to measure every time. To keep our siding running straight on every row and level, we chalk lines between our little crow's feet, and that'll keep each row running straight and level. Tip number three is to get a coat of paint on all of these boards before you put them up. So you get one coat on the ground, one coat once it's put up on the wall, and that'll save you so much time. So we just set these up on a sawhorse, paint them one good coat. And one thing that's hard to do if you're a perfectionist is to leave this 3/16 gap on butt joints, so that these boards can expand and contract a little bit. It's tempting to want to butt them tight, but should leave this gap, caulk it, and if it sinks in a little bit like that, just come back. After painting one coat, get yourself another coat of caulk to kind of fill that in again and paint over it again. Like I said, that's kind of hard to do when you're a perfectionist, but otherwise this stuff could buckle up and come off the wall. Don't want that. We were leaving an 1/8-inch gap on the ends to the corner board, which is spec on this product.
Another way to save time and get really good cuts on these butt joints is to set up a massive chop saw cut station where you can have the full 16 foot length of the board hanging off whichever way you want to cut on it, and you'll get a nice square cut and the board won't sag and kind of drop to the ground when you get done cutting. Awesome. Last but not least, it is super important to seal up any of the cut edges of this product. So we've either painted two coats or caulked every one of these cut butt ends. If we rip a board, you know, and you get a non-painted, non-primed edge, we paint or caulk that whole edge. Otherwise, these ends, let me get a board that's not. Otherwise, these ends can soak in moisture and swell, and that'd be the main bad thing that could happen to the siding. But if you seal it up right, you won't have a problem with it.